I'm John. I'm a chemist by training. I'm originally from the UK, and I'm now a postdoctoral researcher in Christian Schmidt's group here at the University of Florida in Gainesville. My research in the Schmidt Lab is developing biodegradable plastic electronic devices to implant inside the body in order to control cell behavior or to develop materials which respond to electrical stimuli so that you can develop drug delivery systems. I realised when I was at high school that I had a passion for chemistry, and so I decided to go to university to study it. And I was quite lucky to enjoy internships in industry. So these enjoyable experiences kind of encouraged me to go on to grad school. So I moved to York in the UK, and I was developing polymer-based therapeutics there. And during grad school, I had the opportunity to come to the US for the first time. After I had been in grad school, I moved to France to work with a guy who had won the Nobel Prize for Chemistry, and I was learning how molecules interact with one another, and that was really good fun. So I moved on to Germany to work in a field of protein engineering, where we were developing materials which were spider silk mimetic materials for biomaterials applications. What I really enjoy about working in different countries is that you get a really interesting insight into the cultures. So there's a very different working culture in the UK from France and Germany and the States. I would say in all of these, it's been enjoyable and educational, and I've definitely learned a lot from each of my different mentors.
When we synthesize molecules like these have got aniline in the backbone. Aniline is a monomer which allows you to generate a polymer which responds to electricity or electrochemical stimuli. You can change the oxidation state on the backbone of these polymers, and in doing so you can change their colour and their electrical properties.
Knee failure is an incredibly common part of research, particularly when you're trying to push the boundaries of what's been achieved in science already. It's really common for experiments to fail, and the key kind of quality of a good researcher is to be able to learn from your mistakes and to be able to dissect where you've gone wrong, and to try and make progress so that you don't repeat the same mistake again, and so that you can improve the design if you get experiments. And another key quality is to be able to pick yourself up and come back into the lab the next day with the same degree of enthusiasm in the lab before those experiments are failed. Thank you.